You see that there are two different things. It's not just, they are not just the same. On the cross, we're going to be looking at the ordeals that Jesus Christ went through. Carrying the cross is another thing. Before he carried the cross, it was another thing. After he had been sentenced to die, or sentenced to death, then he did not carry the cross. And as he was carrying the cross, there was beating. Are you understanding what I'm saying?
Yeah.
And that cross was not easy to carry. And as we already know, every child of God on planet Earth, although that have gone to heaven, they carried their cross. Just kind of came to show us that he carried the cross, and we are going to carry our own cross. So now, on the cross, there were many things that went, that happened on the cross. That we today, that when we are passing, when we are carrying our cross, and inside that cross or on that cross, whatever we see on that cross, we should hold on to the cross. Amen. It's like examination. You cannot write half examination. You cannot write examination. Examination, you say, okay, I think I don't want to complete it. You have started school. Some people do it. They reach primary three. They say they don't want to continue again. Some of them reach a class two or five class. One in secondary school, they say they don't want to continue again. So university, they reach a year two or year three, they say they don't want to continue again. But in this wise, we must continue. Jesus Christ started it. He carried the cross. Now on the cross, and on the cross he died. So, I said, this on the cross refers to the ordeal that Jesus Christ went through. Why on the cross? The insult, the mockery, the beating. He needed water to drink. They mixed with vinegar. They gave him vinegar mixed with dark. That's so bitter. Go ahead, Pastor Jesus Christ. All that Jesus Christ went through for the salvation of mankind, who did not recognize him, he was patient till he gave up the ghost on the cross. The cross is the hardest way for a man to be killed or to be sentenced to die. It's, like I said on Friday, I said, it's a slow, painful death that he experienced. Not for himself, but for you and for me. Look at the picture now. If I ask how many of you will die for the church today? How many of you will die for your husband, for your wife, for your children, even for your friend? Even if you do, it does not carry with you because your blood is even dirty. Hello?
Yes.
Did the Lord help us in Jesus Christ?
Amen.
Did the Lord help us in Jesus Christ?
Amen.
So we are going to be reading from the book of Matthew chapter 27. Matthew chapter 27. From 37. You know, at times the trend of things, we sometimes don't even know what is going on in the trend of things. God will help Christians in the name of Jesus Christ. God will help you and I in the name of Jesus Christ. Now we'll just, okay, let's just start from there. Let me start from verse 32. He said, and as they came out, they found a man of Cyrene, Simon by name. He and they compared to bear his cross. And when they were come unto the place called Golgotha, that is to say, a place of a skull. Therefore, they gave him vinegar to drink, mingled with gall. And when he had tasted thereof, he would not drink. And they crucified him, and parted his garment, casting lots, that it might be fulfilled which was spoken by the prophet. They parted my garments among them, and upon my vesture did they cast lots. That's it. And sitting down, they washed him there, and set up over his head, his accusation written, "This is Jesus, the King of the Jews." Then were two thieves crucified with him, one on the right hand, and another on the left. And they that passed by, mark this from verse 8 and from verse 7, that will mark that, that's the, we are going to talk on. And 39. And they that passed by revived him, wagging their heads, and saying, "Thou that destroyed the temple, and buildest it in 3 days, save thyself, if thou be the Son of God, come down from the cross." Likewise also the chief priests, mocking him with scribes and elders, said, "He saved others, himself he cannot save. If he be the King of Israel, let him now come down from the cross, and we will believe him. He trusted in God. Let him deliver himself now. If we will have him, is for he said, 'I am the Son of God.'" The thieves also, which were crucified with him, cast the same in his teeth. Now from the sixth hour, there was darkness all over the land until the ninth hour. And about the ninth hour, Jesus cried with a loud voice, saying, "Eli, Eli, lama sabachthani?" That is to say, my God, why hast thou forsaken me?" Some of them that stood there, when they heard that, said, "This man called for Elijah." And straight away, one of them ran and took a sponge and filled it with vinegar and put it on his reed, on a reed, and gave him to drink. The rest said, let us see whether Elijah will come to save him." Jesus, when he had cried again with a loud voice, yielded all the ghost. Like I said, I talk about the cross. Before the cross, determination. You must be determined before you can carry your cross. And when you are carrying the cross, that's the cross that you will be on. So now Jesus Christ is already on the cross. People were making mockery. We are talking about nonsensical things about him. "You said you are the man of God. You are the Jesus Christ. You said you will destroy the building of the church, and you will build it in 3 days. Let me tell you, is that the right time to tell somebody something like that? No. And the Lord said, you save others. Why can't you save yourself now?" The thieves also came. "You save others. Why can't you save yourself? You were making mouth, now you make your mouth." The soldiers and everybody, they were talking nonsensical statement about him. You may not understand the gravity of those words that were said to Jesus Christ. It's like insult upon injury. You know, when you get injured, somebody still insults you to join you. It's very, very painful. But he knew exactly what he was doing. Can Jesus Christ not really save himself? If at all we do not know his life story, but we knew that he called Lazarus from the grave. Even if we don't even know anything about him, we know that he walked on top of water. Yes, sir. Eh? Even we don't even know anything about Jesus Christ. He commanded fish for Peter to cut, to catch. Remember that story?
Yes.
Even though we don't know anything, he made miracle of two fish and five loaves and fed millions of more than 5,000 men. Children and women, they're not counting. And at the end of the day, they will see 12 baskets left over. So which means Jesus Christ knew what he was doing. Even when people were saying something about it that don't matter, he kept quiet because he knew what he was doing. He was focused on the cross. It was not a sweet thing. It was not suitable. And when he needed water, they gave him a vinegar mixed with gall. How many people know Peter Lee? You have enough, please.
Yes, sir.
Peter Lee. So, even bitter leaf, when they squeeze it, the liquid, the juice, you can't take it. Amen. And it's very, very important, that water, that juice that comes out of it. But it cannot. So Jesus Christ went through this ordeal on the cross. Today, Jesus Christ, what would Jesus Christ do for you? He have a point, he have a case that you and I might be saved. Otherwise, he could have just called one legion to finish up them. And he will be saved. Not that Jesus Christ did not come to buy house here. He came to fulfill what God has already planned from the beginning. And before he came, all the prophets have been prophesying concerning him. So he was not doing exactly, he was not fulfilling exactly the prophecy that had been prophesied by all the old and the major prophets in the Bible. So that means that he was working according to the plan of God. Not for God, not for him, but for you and I. So for this reason, we must put ourselves together and do whatever he tells us to do by worshiping him in truth and the spirit. Somebody died for you, but you cannot be able, and Jesus can just say, come and die for me now. Somebody have died for you. How can you repay him back? The only thing that he needed from you and I is just simple. Worship me in truth and the spirit. Is that not too big for us to do? No. Jesus Christ completed his mission on earth and said, it is a finish. As long as you are still on planet earth here, you cannot say it is finished. You know what? Finished in Greek, thank God, in the Greek language, means teleos. The Greek word, they carry power. And when they say teleos, it's over. Over. Finished. And this is what people that do race, 10,000 kilometer race, at the end of the day, they put that finishing line or finishing tape. Then the one that finished will use his chest to remove the ribbon. Is it ribbon or the tape? Amen. It's like, are you people okay? Or you are just enjoying? Are you not flowing? I mean, yeah. It's only so it means when you are running, you see that, and they are very happy to do like this, to put their chest to remove the something. Eh? That's me. You have reached the mark. Just like I said, it is finished. It means that I have done what I need to do for you. It means that if you make heaven or you don't make heaven, you are the cause. I have come to pay for it for you. That you will not pay for your own with your own blood. So it is finished. Even the authority I have given unto you, It is settled that you use that authority to order, so for you to also finish what you need to finish in life. And if you want to analyze that, sickness is finished. Yeah. Backbone is finished. Yeah. Death is finished. Yeah. Every plan of the enemy is finished. Just to apply the name of Jesus Christ. Because at the name of Jesus Christ, every knee should bow. And every tongue shall confess that is Lord to the glory of the Father which is in heaven. That is the finished work on the cross of Calvary. I also went further in the book of Colossians. Colossians chapter 2, verse 14. Somebody can somebody read from there. Colossians chapter 2, verse 14. Amen. He said that he has nailed, let me paraphrase it. He has come to name every handwriting of the enemy. You know what to name? To name is to hammer them. To hammer the curse of the enemy. Amen. Amen. He has come to name it to the cross. So it was on the cross he settled everything for you and I. So if you, as a child of God, you say you are a Christian, you say you are born again, you say you are a follower of Jesus Christ, you are still experiencing what you are not supposed to experience, then check your life. I've checked my life. Am I really serving him to God's Spirit? On Friday, we also said that we read it, we said that Jesus Christ said, if you want to save your life, you will lose it. But if you lose your life for my name's sake, you will gain it. Are you getting now? So we tell you that your life that you are living should not be yours, but Jesus Christ. It is finished, means it is already settled. What is that problem that you are passing through? Just can say it is finished.
Amen.
What is that case that you are crying about? Say it is finished.
Amen.
What is that your document that is not forthcoming? It is settled.
Amen.
Except your side is not on your side. Amen. How many people say, Brother Samuel? There was a time, Brother Samuel was saying, oh, my document has not come out. My document has not come out. Daddy, I'll be going to be there. I'm going to say, don't worry. Don't worry. Don't worry. But today, I think you are happy now. They did not renew for you, they gave me passport.
Yeah.
You have a passport. Now let me tell you, it's not finished yet. What will you do with that passport that God has given to you? Matters a lot. That passport can finish poverty. That passport can finish death. That passport can finish poverty. So Jesus said, it is finished. There's things that Jesus has given to us. Amen. And if you are not giving your life, if you are not cutting your own is already settled. It's settled. Everything about you is already settled in heaven. But being that as it may, if you are not walking to the instruction, according to the instruction of God, of the word of God, that way it will never be settled for some people. If your skin has been settled, then you see the result. Amen.
Amen.
He said, it is finished. What is the meaning of this finish? Anything that will not make you to serve you well, anything that will make you to be sad, anything that will make you, that will not make you to be whom you are supposed to be, he said, it is finished.
Yeah.
But because there is a finish, don't mean that. You don't experience certain things. Because if you look at yourself, he said, he that said it is finished, look at what, is, what he passed through. Eh? So you also pass through this hurdle. And this hurdle that the thing that will make you to be matured as a Christian. Tell me a medical doctor. Show me any medical doctor. I'll tell you. I will tell you that he went to school. For 7 good years, don't be going to school. Go to school. That's why you respect them. I get you. That's why they are making a guy for you. And they continue to make God. The time they spend, if you spend it, you also know the value. What Jesus Christ did, if you pass through it, you will know the value of being hung on the tree. So some of you, they are not. Amen.
Amen.
Somebody talk to you. Is it like what like Moses said? Say so. They spat on him. They make mockery of him on the cross. You are not on the cross. Somebody said he lied against me. He said I cannot go to church again. It's like I will not do again. That's immaturity. And it's filled up in the church today. Over the place. You see a bundle of immature Christians. No wonder the Bible said that let him take his stand, take it him, let him fall. You think that somebody just standing, it's one thing that even a child will laugh over. You just take it like see it is finished, like just I said. Something you don't laugh over. You needed water. They gave him vinegar and gone. He couldn't drink it. He still went. Even people that he came to die for, they were mocking him. Like today, people making mockery of him. You focus. Amen. I told Donnie, I said that I love one can become focused, full focus. Amen. If you are focused, you don't know who is making mockery of you. It's because you don't have job. That's why you are listening to people that are already frustrated. Even people in the church. He gossiped me. He lied about me. He used one eye to look me. Those are things that these small children can even do that. An adult like you, like us, is not put in your mind. I'm not sad money, I'm not going to church again. If somebody can do you that you don't go to church then, you are done. That person is done for. Let nobody stop you. As they were doing to Jesus Christ, the more they pay, the more the glory. Today, when evil men, whether Muslim or like it or not, today, they are holiday. I get it now. Whether Christian or not Christian, the name of the Lord is already there. No matter the Bible says, the name of the Lord is a strong tower. The righteous are into it and they are saved. Who are the righteous? The ones that are already made up their mind to follow Jesus Christ. They are the righteous ones. Will they be paid? Yes. Don't believe those people that say, once we are in Jesus Christ, everything will just be fear, good, fear, money will flow, health will flow, everything is a lie from Gehenna. That's why many people are frustrated today. Let me tell you. The Bible tells me in the book of Philippians chapter 2, verse 12 to 14. It says that we must work at our salvation with fear and trembling. That walking is that you will work it on your own. I will work it on my own. And the reason, the only way we can only work together is when we come together to encourage ourselves. That's to say that you cannot do it on your own. You need somebody to encourage you. How many people need the encouragement here? If you don't need the encouragement, you come and encourage me. Amen. As long as you are living on earth, you will need encouragement. There are things you cannot pass through, that you pass through. You need the encouragement of others. That's why the Bible says in Proverbs chapter 27, verse 17, it says, iron sharpened iron. So the countenance of a man shaping his friend or brother. That's why we need fellowship. That's why we share things together. But though the ones that are matured in the Lord. Amen. I get it now.
Yes, sir.
That's the reason. Whenever you are passing through tough time, hard time, you know that your miracle is almost there.
Amen.
The darkest part of the night is when the day is about to be done. Are you getting it?
Yes, sir.
The thickest part of the tunnel is just about to enter the open place. So what are you passing through that just kind of did not pass through? Tell me. Okay, what he passed through. If we can be able to endure till the last, will wear the crown of life. So that's what Jesus came to pay for on the cross. As you are carrying your own cross, let us use Mr. Job as an example in the Bible. Job carried his own cross very well. I get that. But there were people that were telling him, just you know, you are done for. He lost his wife. He lost his wife. He lost his children. He lost his job. To add insult to injury, he became very ill. And there were friends that were telling him, why don't you just call God? You say you are serving God, you are a servant of God, you are a servant of God. Look at the everything. Yeah, let me tell you. A servant of God does not mean that you are immune against hardship. A servant of God does not mean, a child of God does not mean that you are immune against sickness. It will come. But when it comes, how will you react? If you read the Bible very well, the book of Job, it said that Job served God very well. He's a righteous man. No sin in him. Yet, all this happened to him. And as it was happening to him, just as it's our own person, that's our own day to day. When you are passing through some certain things in life, that's your cross. And there are people that come and make mockery of you. Hello? But if you know who you are in the Lord, you don't allow that mockery to do anything in you. And don't pass from one stage to another. If you look at because there's almost more than 30 chapters or 42. All of them about the story. And at the end of the day, when everything is said and done, when everything is finished, the story from the beginning now changed at the end. The Bible declared that whatever Job had was restored to him in double. Why? He finished carrying his cross. What is your cross that you are carrying today? And who are the people making mockery of you? Who are the people that are giving, so instead of giving you water, they are giving you vinegar. Instead of encouraging you, they are doing whatever. But Jesus Christ started the cross and he finished it. He finished it and two boldly said to us that it is finished. And as it is at that point that he said it is finished, that our victory now comes. So when we also do the same thing, victory will always come on at the end of finishing the process. At the end of your trial, at the end of your temptation, at the end of your struggling, at the end of your fighting, at the end of your world of sickness, there will always be it is finished. And it is at that point that you start seeing victory.
Amen.
Amen. We have started in order to finish in life. Or let me put it away. What have you started in order to finish in your life as a follower of Jesus Christ? What are those things? Number one, this race we are running. Amen. We have to finish it. Are you understand what I'm saying?
Yes, sir.
How many Christians do we have here? How many Christians do we have here?
Okay, one. Only one.
Okay. How many Christians do we have here?
No, I'm not sure.
Amen. You start from there, the cross. Amen. If you must be a follower of Jesus Christ, what is that thing now that you need to finish in your life? I said, number one is the race. As a child of God, there is a race that has been set before us. And we must finish it. That the Lord will say, welcome, thou faithful and good servant. Come and enter into your rest. And that race started from the day you got born again. It's not the day you were born. It's a spiritual race. That's why we must be very careful. As you are running the race, the devil will come and fight you. As you are running the race, you come and make mockery of you. As you are running the race, something will happen on the way. As you are running the race, you even that frustration is coming up. I've already learned there are things that you need that to run the race. You're like, you're not getting some certain things. It's like you want to throw your towel into the ring. No. We have to finish the race. We have started, we must finish it. And before you can finish that race, you have to be very, very careful. The only means with which all that will do is continually studying the Word of God. It is the Word of God that will give you encouragement. It is the Word of God that will make you to feel that if anything is wrong in your life, you can get corrected. It's the Word of God that is like a mirror that will be used to see yourself and know where the spots are and clean them up. And clean them off. What have you started in order to finish in your life? Like I said, your Christian race. And that's what the devil is fighting you. The way the devil fought with Jesus Christ, he will fight you very well. Can't remember Jesus Christ. Jesus Christ was determined to carry his cross, and he's on the cross. Even as he's on the cross, God help us in Jesus Christ. Do you know that the sort of day that were making mockery of him, they were the one that ate the five loaves and two fishes.